Thank you for joining. I'd like to share with you three of my favorite soothing lower body stretches for the low back, the back of the legs, and the hips using the bender ball. This comes from our bender ball series. Let's position the bender ball under the lower back. We'll come down to the floor. We'll place the ball underneath the lower back area so that it supports the lumbar spine. Very gently, we can draw one knee towards the other, in towards the chest. Now, if this exercise is new for you, I would suggest keeping the elbows on the floor. Keep the legs slightly parted as you slowly take the thighs towards your belly. Here, we can enjoy 5 deep breaths. It's one of the most soothing lower back and spinal and gluteal stretches. Should be really comfortable. Allow the weight to settle into your upper back and not on your head or your neck. After a few breaths, we'll take one foot down to the floor. So I'll position my left foot on the floor with the knee bent and very gradually start to unravel this right leg up towards the ceiling for a hamstring stretch. Start to press the heel up to the ceiling and then pull it back in. We'll do that 3 times in motion here. Lift. Finding length through the back part of your leg. These exercises are great after any activity or sport, or even at the end of the day when we just want to gently relax and restore our natural energy. Now let's hold the leg up there. You can keep a soft bend in the knee here if you'd like. Interlace the fingers behind the thigh and start to point and flex the foot. So a lot of variations for our hamstring stretch. I like to bring all of the joints into it to improve the elasticity, suppleness of that deep connective tissue from the foot all the way up towards the hip. And if it's accessible, we can lengthen the leg a little bit more, press the heel upwards towards the ceiling, enough to be able to feel sensation through the back of the legs, the calf, hamstring, right up towards your glute. Allow the shoulders and arms to stay soft. And again, if you're feeling a little off balance, keep your elbows on the floor as you do that hamstring stretch. Let's come into our third move here. Cross the right ankle over the left knee in a figure 4 stretch. The pelvis stays neutral and really supported on the ball. The right hand, we can gently press the right knee away, allowing that right foot to stay flexed. So that's a nice option to stay, especially if you feel tight hips or the rotators in and around the hip. You might want to stay here and just breathe at least 6 deep breaths. Each one of these 3 moves is perfect. As a second option to allow us to go a little deeper, placing the elbows on the floor, we lift the left foot off of the floor as we draw the thighs towards us. The idea here is to pull the left thigh inwards and actively press the right knee away from you, getting that opening here through the piriformis, allowing for the glute stretch, hips, lower back. Slow and deepen your breath as you hold these stretches. This is another one of my favorites for the hips. And then gradually position the left foot down on the floor, followed by the right. And let's do the same thing on the other side. So you can either return to that first movement, which was the lower back stretch. Take a few breaths to realign. Right foot comes down to the floor this time. Second move is the hamstring. Without extending the leg completely the first time, we can bend and extend the knee. Fill the lungs, slow the breath down to savor that movement. If that's a little too intense for the calf or the hamstring, or you have sciatic nerve sensitivity, keep the foot pointed as opposed to flexed. So play with the angle of your ankle and find the angle that feels just right for you. Get ready to hold it. Initially, perhaps keeping a slight bend in the knee, point and flex the ankle here in the foot. Spread the toes nice and wide. Notice the mobility of your ankle, the motion at your ankle, any sensations through the calf, the back of your leg. Gradually moving deeper into the hamstrings by pressing the heel up to the ceiling. And just find a range of motion where you can straighten the leg. Sometimes we need to drop it down a little bit to get the leg straight and then gradually guide it towards us. Without bouncing, Just a nice slow movement in. Breathe out until you find where you get just the right amount of stretch and sensation without any kind of shakiness. There may be a bit of intensity, and that's okay. I feel the back of my leg heating up a little bit. A gentle tremble, so I'm just going to release it maybe quarter of an inch, half an inch. Good. And we move to the final movement here. The three lower body soothing stretches, figure four. Cross the ankle over the knee. Press the knee gently away from you. Fill the lungs completely. Just breathe slow, all systems down. Second option, either the foot on the floor or take the thigh towards your chest. As the right thigh draws in, you can guide the left hand on the inside of the knee to move it away from your body. Elbows either off the floor, hovering, or on the floor for greater support and stability. After your five or six deep breaths there, you can release to hug both knees back into the chest where we began. And that completes our three soothing stretches for the lower body series. Enjoy.